Good morning, dear students. Welcome back to Maths class. I hope all of you are fine and healthy. Today, let us see the new chapter of 7th class. The chapter name is Lines and Angles. Lines and Angles. So in your earlier classes, you might have studied some of the basic points related to this, isn't it? So what is the meaning of lines? You know, how to draw the lines. You have drawn different kinds of lines. Whether this is a line is, whether we'll call it as line, yes, it's also line. But this is called as straight line. This is called as straight line. This is called as also straight line. This is called as curve. Curve. Okay. You won't call it as line. It is called as curve. It is one kind of line. So what is the meaning of lines? Where we can draw lines? Lines can be drawn on a plane. What is a plane? Plane means planar surface. It should be flat. So we usually will draw lines on a paper. In a paper we will draw. On a board we will draw. Isn't it? So lines can be drawn on a plane surface. So what is the meaning of line? Lines are the part. There are infinitely many points. We are joining the points. Joining the point, there are infinitely many points. So line is made up of several points and it can be extended in both the directions. Both directions it extends. Understood? Line extends in both the directions. Line. What is the meaning of line? What is the meaning of line? So if you join the points in a plane, we will get lines. So if I cut this line, what we will get? This is what? Line. If I cut this line, I will get the part of a line is called as, suppose if it is AB, that is called as line segment. Isn't it? If I divide a line into two parts, then I will get this is called as ray, isn't it? So what is line? There are infinitely many points. If we join points in a straight way, we will get straight line or line. If I cut this line, I will get line segment. Okay, this is A point, suppose this is B point. It extends in both the directions. If I cut these, and get AB is a part of line. Line segment is a part of line. If I again divide it into two parts, one part is called as ray. Ray can be extended in only one direction. Only one direction. Understood? So it is line, this is line segment, this is ray. So what is the meaning of angles? Angles. You can see here one line, one ray, isn't it? One more ray can you see here? Yes. Both rays start from a common point, that is O. This is called as angle. When angle is formed, if two or more rays start from a common point, then angle forms. Two or more rays originate from the common point. Understood? This is called as common point. OA and OB are two rays. When it starts from the common point, we will get an angle. So when angle forms, two or more rays start from a common point. If three rays are there, then we will get two angles. If four rays are there, then we will get three angles, like that. So if two or more rays start from a common point, angle is formed. How many types of angles are there? There are different kinds of angles. Suppose this is a first ray, 2A. If I draw here, you can see clearly two rays. If I draw three rays, here two rays. If I draw two rays, if I draw two rays. Suppose one more ray lie on the same line. Got it? Actually, if it is here, you can see. Suppose this line lies down, lies on the same line. Suppose this line lies on the same line. Then angle forms. This angle is called as zero angle. What? Zero angle. 0 degree. The first kind of angle is zero angle. Second one is, suppose this is the one ray, this is one more ray, B, then angle forms is, it is nothing but 0 to 90 degree. If it is like this, it is 90 degree, isn't it? 0 to 90 degree, then it is called as acute angle. The second kind of angle is acute angle. Acute angle is angle between 0 to 90, I mean 10, 20, 30, 40, these are acute angles. The third one is, it is common for all the figures, A. Suppose the angle formed is 90 degree, then it is called as what? Right angle. What? Right angle. Right means 90 degree. Right angle. Suppose the angle is like this, it is more than 90. More than 90, but less than 180. Suppose if it is less than 180, then it is called as a obtuse angle. The fourth one is obtuse angle. Suppose angle is like this. And so what I am saying, this is A. One more line is here. It comes here. It comes here. Suppose it comes like this, then angle form is 180 degree. That is called as straight angle. Straight angle. That is fifth one, isn't it? Now sixth one is, suppose if it is more than 180, more than 180, more than 180, then it is called as what? It is called as reflex angle. What? Reflex angle. Suppose again, this is A. One more ray stands here, comes here, comes here, comes here. So this is what? Acute. Right angle. This is obtuse. Now it is right angle. No, suppose if it comes like this, again lies down here. These are entirely different. Entirely different. Okay? This is first way. This is lie down. From here this starts. Now after going here, suppose comes to the same position, then it is called as 360 degree. So this angle is called as complete angle. Complete angle. So in all these you have seen two rays. When two rays originate from a common point, angle is formed. There are different types of angles. The first angle is a right angle. Second is acute angle, third is right angle, fourth is obtuse, fifth is right angle, sixth is reflex angle, then the seventh is complete angle. There are different kinds of angles. Now, let's see, other than these, there are some more kinds of angles. The first one is, so related angles, the first one is complementary angles. So what you mean by complementary angles? So I will draw two angles. Okay, I will draw two angles. Suppose this is 30 degree, this is 60 degree. Two more angles I will draw. Suppose this is 45 degree, so 40 degree I will take up. This is 50 degree. What is the sum of these? What is the sum of these? Sum of these two angles is 90 degree. Isn't it? So, sum of two angles measures 90 degree. Then these angles are called as complementary angles. What is the meaning of complementary? Sum of any two angles. Here angles are defined by different angles. If you add these, sum of two angles measures 90 degree are called as complementary angles. Suppose the question they may ask, what is the complementary angle of, question is like this, what is the complementary angle of 35 degree? We know what is the meaning of complementary angle. Sum of angles should be 90 degree. In that, what is the complementary of 35 means one angle is given. What about the second angle? This question. How we can find? So if you subtract 35 from 90, what you will get? You will get 55. So 55 is the complementary angle of 35 degree. If you add this, you will get 90 degree. So what is the complementary angle of 87 degree? What is the complementary angle of 87? 87 plus how much is equal to 90? That is the question. So the answer is 3 degree. What is the complement of 17 degree? The complementary angle of 17 degree is 73 degree, because sum of these two should be 90. This is called as what? Complementary angles. Sum of two angle measures 90 degree are called as complementary. Second one is supplementary. What is supplementary angle? The word itself indicates supplementary. Supplementary angles. What is the meaning of supplementary angles? So I will draw all these figures. See, suppose this is a 110 degree. This is 70. Suppose this is 150 degree. This is 30 degree. So what about the sum of these two? Sum of these two is 180. What about the sum of these two? It is also 180. Can I guess? So what is supplementary? The sum of two angle measures 180 degree. Sum of two angle measures 180 degree are called as supplementary angles. Complementary means 90, supplementary means 180. So what is the supplementary angle of 110 degree? We need to get 180. What is question mark? Second angle. What is the supplementary of 110? Supplementary of 110 is 70 degree. What is the supplementary of 73 degree? We should get 180 degree. So what is the supplementary of 360 degree? 180 degree. What is the complementary of 73 degree? The complementary of 73 is how much? To get 180, so 107, isn't it? 107 plus 73 is 180 degree. It's called as complementary angle. Again, if two angles are acute, then we will get complementary angles. Sorry, yes, complementary. If one is obtuse, one is acute, then we will get, for example, see, the angle which is less than 90 degree are called as complementary, 50 and 40. This is 40. Now what happens? This is 140. Then only we will get 180, isn't it? So in that, one is obtuse, other is acute. Sum of obtuse and acute angle is supplementary. Sum of two acute angles gives complementary. Can sum of two obtuse angles gives supplementary? No, because if you add these two, it is more than 180 degree. It is not equal to 180, more than 180.
So now the next one is
next question is, see like this, two angles are equal and two angles are equal and supplementary. Question, this is two angles are equal and supplementary. Find the angles. Find the angles. What is the meaning of this? Two angles are equal. Two angles are equal and supplementary. Suppose the angles are, two angles are equal means let the angle be x. Let the angle be x. Isn't it? Two angles are equal means x and x, these two are angles. Are supplementary means if you add these two, you will get 180. That is questions. Two angles are equal and they are supplementary. If you add these two angles, you get 180 degree. Two angles are equal and complementary means x plus x is equal to 90 degree. Understood? So x plus x is equal to 2x is equal to 180 degree. So x is equal to 180 degree. 2 comes this side, divides. So x is equal to how many times? 2, 90s are. So the angles are 90 degree and other angles also 90 degree. If it is complementary, then what you will get? X plus x is equal to 90, 2x is equal to 90, x is equal to 45 degree. So that is called as two angles are equal and they are supplementary. When you add that angle, you will get 180 degree. Complementary means when you add that angle, you will get 90 degree. The next kind of angle is linear, adjacent angles. Let's see first. Adjacent angles. Adjacent angles. You know the meaning of adjacent? Adjacent means one after other, one beside other. So one beside other. These classrooms are adjacent. This classroom and opposite classrooms are adjacent. Adjacent means one wall is common to both the rooms. Suppose the figure is like this. How many rays are there? 3 rays. O, A, this is OB and this is OC. Let's take. Okay. This is angle 1, this is angle 2. Whether these two angles are adjacent? Yes, as I said, one wall is common to two rooms. One wall is common to two rooms. This is called as a wall. Suppose, if it is the wall, this is one room, this is other room. This wall is common to both the rooms. Similarly, this ray is common to both the angles. Such an angles are called as adjacent angles. So, angle 1 and angle 2 are adjacent. Nothing but angle AOC and angle BOC are adjacent. Understood? Adjacent angle means what? If two angles in a angles, if one ray is common. So what is the properties of adjacent angles? In adjacent angles, they have one common arm. They have one common arm. Arm is ray. This is the first one. This is the second one, isn't it? This is OC. This is OC. Suppose this is OA. This is OB. In this is common. Understood? So the properties of adjacent angle is, suppose this is adjacent angle, it has one common arm and one common point. Both angles starts from a common point, isn't it? Both angles starts from a common point and it has one arm common. So the point A can be stated like this. They have common R and they have common point. R is called as vertex. Understood? Suppose this is the figure. Angle 1 and
linear pair.
Linear pair. Linear pair. What is the meaning of linear pair? Suppose one ray stands on a line. Line means this is what? Again, this is O. Suppose this is OA, OB and OC. These angles are linear pair. Linear pair means what? Sum of these two angles should be 180. Sum of two angle, or this angle can be called as, can you call it as adjacent angles? Yes. One angle after other angle. So it can be called as sum of two adjacent angle is 180 degree, are called as adjacent angles or linear pairs. What do you mean by linear pair? Sum of two adjacent angles is 180, then it is called as linear pair. Suppose same figure is like this. Can you call this as adjacent angles? No, because. Can you call this as linear pair? No, because this is 90. If it comes like this, it is 90. It is somewhat 70. Sum of these two is 90 plus 70 is 160. It is not. Sum should be 180. Sum of these two angles should be 180 and this should be adjacent angles. So, what is linear pair? Sum of two adjacent angles is 180 degree called as linear pair. The next one, third one is a vertically opposite angle. This is the last one. Vertically opposite angle. Vertically opposite angles. The word itself indicates vertically opposite angles. You might have seen scissor or X. Suppose this is point O. Here is one angle. Here is the second angle. This is third angle. This is fourth angle. Could you see OA, OB, OC and OD? Can you show how many angles are there? They are angle 1, 2, 3 and 4. Angle 1 and angle 3 are opposite angles and it is called as vertical opposite angles. So, angle 1 and angle 3 are vertical opposite angles. Same way, angle 2 and angle 4 are vertical opposite angles. One interesting fact is vertically opposite angles are always equal. Vertically opposite angles are always equal. Suppose if it measures 70, this also 70. What about this angle? Again, linear pair, this plus this, this is 110, this also 110. Like this. So, what is the meaning of vertical opposite angles? When two lines intersect each other, the angle forms opposite to one another are called as vertical opposite angles and that two angles are always equal. In this figure, angle 1 and angle 3 are always equal, angle 2 and angle 4 are always equal, vertically opposite angle. Vertices opposite. Angle forms opposite to the vertices, vertices means point, are called as vertical opposite angles. So, these are the different kinds of angles. So this is the part 1 video. One more part is there. Let's see in the next class. I hope you have understood this concept clearly.